Hi guys. Ooh. I've had a busy day. I'm a bit out of breath because I've just come upstairs. I've had quite a cleaning out session in the cupboard on the landing. Sort of threw in a huge pile of bicycle inner tubes. In fact, I near enough filled a trash bag full of punctured ones. I collected up so many, I just didn't know what ones were worth keeping and what weren't, so I just went through and pumped a load up, and the ones that went down got chucked, and the ones that stayed up were let down and put into a box. So, that's all done. And the wheels still haven't been collected. Hang on, it's a bit dark. I'll turn a couple of lights on. There we go. So, I don't know. I did pop out for a couple of minutes, at least twice today. Once this morning, or lunchtime, and once late this afternoon. I didn't actually need to. But never mind. So I wouldn't be surprised if they turned up then, but they usually give 3 attempts to collect anyway. So if they did turn up today and I weren't here, they should come back tomorrow. I get the Apollo ready to sell, the black and red suspension bike, because I've got that Silver Fox to go and get next week. But don't want to sell that one until I've put the wheels from the ladies' Apollo that I've got sitting down at the workshop at Mum in this one, because I want to keep the wheels because they're a decent pair. So I'll do that probably Thursday, because Mum's got quite a busy week with appointments and whatnot, and people visiting, and she's just got a hectic week. So aside from having a good old sort out in that outside cupboard, in fact I think I could go back in there and throw a few more items out, I've just been having a switch around here on the desk. That's empty, as you can see. Change the contents of those, because all the Lego minifigures, spare parts and accessories are in these 3 cases now. I've seen a lot of people do that on a lot of Facebook groups and elsewhere online, so that's what I've done. And I've freed up several of these large drawers so I could sort the windows whatnot up to here, actually. And then there's just a couple and a couple of tubs there, and some tubs up there. Just temporarily till I get another. How many tubs have I got? 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'll need at least another one of these big ones. Which I could go get tomorrow, I suppose. If I've got the change in my pocket. Damn it, I've got a door. Oh well. I'm actually just wondering, because those are quite long drawers over there, so I could, the ones that are sort of split into 2 or 3 sections, I could split in at the rest of these, actually. Then that'll free up those drawers for something else. Exactly what yet, I don't know. Or I could just leave it as it is, because it's working as it is, to be honest. Oh, actually, no, it's not. I know one thing I can do. I've got all those in here. I can change those later. I've got to remember where I put the rest of these. I had them out the other day, now I can't remember where I put them. Somewhere around here. Just got that to repair. I had to nick some bricks out of it for a model I was building. I'll tell you what we can do. I haven't done it yet. I know these are LEDs and don't use a lot, but still, I don't need them on if I'm not using them, do I? I turn them on when I'm using them. What we'll do, I don't know how well I can do it one-handed, so I might have to sit you down. But I'm going to go through these discs and see if they're worth... Well, that one can be cleaned, and that'll be alright to go to a charity shop. I could do that tomorrow, actually. Grand Theft Auto Liberty City Stories. I can't get the disc off. What's that one like? That might as well go in the bin. That is scratched to shit. It's probably why they were taken down the recycling centre, actually, because they were scratched to shit. But, so there's something for the recycling. Case. If the case breaks, I've got spares. Well, spares for other discs. Now, what about these Xbox games? They're complete. I could try them on it. Yeah, right. Okay. That's, why did I put that back in there? Scratched the shit. I've got a funny feeling most of these are... Put the recycling down there. Can't remember what gets collected tomorrow. I believe it's just normal household waste. I think recycling is next week. Because I alternate collections around here. Yeah, I'm pretty certain it's household waste. So I've been trying to check out what I can. What's this one like? Well played. Here's another one. Another one. A bit of a recycling nut as well. I just want the Xbox cases because they're a nice green colour. Next one. We will get a feeling it's going to be the same story throughout. That's not as bad, but I don't see the point in donating one game, to be honest. And there's no point trying to sell a game in that condition. Whoever had these games did not look after them. My games are in a heck of a lot better condition than these. So I look after them. Suppose that's one bonus with modern PlayStations and PC games. You actually don't download a digital version of the game rather than have a hard copy, because hard copies always get damaged. But at least with a digital copy, you can back it all up or download it again, and there's no risk of the disc skipping or getting stuck halfway through a game or a mission. There's nothing worse than that. So I suppose there's a lot of advantage to have them download the games. Instead of the old hard disk copies like this. I do like having the hard disk copies though. But I see a lot of advantage in the download to your hard drive copies as well that you can get, even do believe you can do that with the PlayStation 4. Right. Bin. Those hard drives can go in the cupboard as well. Found that speaker in the outside cupboard as well. I was going to connect that to my hi-fi and I'm not actually sure where I was going to put it. Could mount it on the wall in front of me, so when I'm sitting at this computer I'll have surround sound. I'll have a speaker behind me up there and one in front of me, but there's no point. Not really, because if I really wanted to listen to the radio while I was sitting here, for example, I can just go to the radio station website and click on Listen Live. And I can listen to it through here, although their new player seems to be glitchy. Which is why I don't listen to it through their player on the website much. They changed the player, but that does seem to glitch now and again. Although, it doesn't cut out like the old one used to. The old one just used to randomly cut out. Some of my items I bought on eBay have been dispatched, apparently. Which is good. Well, then again, just because I haven't marked as dispatched on eBay doesn't mean they haven't posted it. Because sometimes they don't. Even I've done that. You see, that one's not marked as dispatched there. The parcel symbol should be lit up like... Oh, I swear that one was. Like this, anyway. Oh yeah, the cable has. My RF cable and this lot of Lego has, but according to the feedback's been left, but according... But like I said, that doesn't mean anything, because sometimes the seller will post and not, and forget to mark it as dispatched on eBay. So that's not bad. Keep forgetting to get the Dell rails as well. I need those for the, is it an Optiplex? I can't remember. It's on top of the wardrobe anyway. I wanted to get that up and running because it works. I just haven't got the, rails for the hard drive and whatnot. How much are they? Oh, $289. That isn't much. Not much at all. Me. Did I leave feedback? Oh yes, Owen, he's left feedback for me as well. Just says feedback received. Sometimes it says positive or negative or whatever received, and other times I'll just say feedback received. I had an accident on my desk. Oh, look at this way I've been using the mouse. So much for me keeping my new desk all nice and tidy and scratch free. Look at this one. Scratches and wear.
Yeah.
Like a cheap bag of crap. I see computer desks in charity shops every now and again, so I'll probably keep this until it starts disintegrating on me. Anyway, yeah, I had an accident with this earlier. I was actually sitting here at this angle trying to unwrap the brand new roll of refuse sacks down there, and my hand slipped and went like that, and of course it knocked straight into my glass of drink and it just went bleh, straight down the back. Luckily it missed the PC. I don't think enough of the PC actually hangs over the back anyway. And I've got the power outlet hanging up there, so It didn't really do any damage apart from soak everything. But that was a good excuse to pull this table out and give it a good vacuum behind there. And retrieve the camera and the microphone that had fallen down the back again. Had a pound for every time I've had to retrieve those. Yeah, there wasn't a lot going online either. It's quiet all round. Did I tell you the wheels haven't been collected? Yeah, I did. So I'm losing track of what I've already said now. Right. Well, I can't go anywhere tomorrow then, because I've got to wait for the courier. So, what I don't do tonight, I'll do tomorrow. Yeah. We'll get this lot cleared up in a minute. That tub of Christmas lights can go in the cupboard in the hallway. That bread box, I'm going to need that bread bin, rather, needs to go somewhere out of the way. It's got to go on the for God's sake. It's got to be mounted on the front of the trailer at some point. But I can't do that while it's full of scrap. And I don't think I've got any more scrap to go on at this moment. I did the Trek frame I had. I was going to take the, hang on a minute. That's better. I was going to take the crank off the Trek frame. But, aluminium crank, steel axle. Those that know about bikes can pretty much guess what had happened and why I didn't bother taking them off. A lot of corrosion, to the point I couldn't actually screw my remover tool into the crank to remove it, so I just didn't bother, because I knew I'd risk either damaging the crank, damaging my tool, or damaging myself in the process, so I just didn't bother. It wasn't worth the hassle. So I took a couple of nice little screws out of the frame for. And actually, I don't know what the screws were there for. They're in a weird position. Obviously to mount something to the frame, but I don't know what. But they were good, so I took those out. But other than that, the rest of it I've just taken down to the trailer and laid on top of scrap. So now, in my cupboard up here, all I've got is the Carrera and my brother's Viking frame. Which is what I wanted the single speed sprocket for off that halo wheel I got in the bedroom. Ooh, that reminds me, I've still got to take a photo of that, put that on eBay. Actually, is anything being watched on eBay, or is it just a complete flop again? Oh, finally, one of my wheel hubs has got two watches. Oh! One of my floppy drives has actually got a watcher as well. Only four views, though. I wonder if I should try changing category, because I don't seem to be getting many views, to be honest. We've got Tokyo Touring Car Championships for PS1, that's had two views in nearly 2 days. That's a view a day. I'm doing something wrong, I think. The other vintage bike parts aren't doing too bad. Yeah, I'm doing something wrong somewhere. I might have to look at the M categories again. That could be the problem. Right. I don't know where I was pointing the camera. My hand just seems to drift every time I take my eyes off the camera. Suppose I should take photos of them police cars. I could try those on eBay. No harm in it, is there? Clear some space off that table. I could do that tonight. Yeah, it won't be too hard to clear some room off there. Find a home for these instruction manuals. Well, I know what I can do because I don't go to them that often. I can tuck them behind the drawers under the display table over there. I'll do in there. And I need to get in the bedroom at some point and have a good muck out in here. A very good muck out. That monitor buried in there is crap. Yeah, I thought I could hear the cat snoring. I thought I was hearing things for a second. Oh well. Right, get in there and get them toy cars at the bottom. I don't know. Do we have anything, you know, worth sticking on eBay in here, to be honest? Yeah, oh, I've got to take a photo of that wheel as well, that can go on. The halo rim. I better take a measurement of the width of that as well, because that's not standard width. I don't think there's any point taking a photo of the width, because there won't be anything to compare it with. So I'll take a... ouch, that's my elbow. I'll take a measurement of that. Yeah. Right, so what I'll do then... make a bit of space on here. I've got a dinky Mark 1 Escort sitting under here somewhere. You know what? That can go on as well. I weren't going to sell it, because I do like it, but... again, what is the point in keeping it when I don't do nothing with them? No, there's a few pounds sitting there at least, because it is in good condition. Oh. That worked. Note to self, roof comes off police van pretty easy. Doesn't go on as easy though. Right, now the question is, can I get all these up in one go? Because I doubt they're heavy. No, not heavy. Not heavy at all. I'm not surprised, there isn't a lot in it. Right, this is my way of clearing some room, we know, we'll just shove it up to one side. I will need these on then, won't I? Actually, saw a video from John Ward. He was comparing LED light bulbs to an incandescent one. To be more precise, a 60 watt incandescent light bulb with a 8 watt LED with LED filaments in it. And to be honest, when they were put side by side, you couldn't see the difference. You wouldn't, if you walked in a lounge or a restaurant or something, you wouldn't notice the difference. Right, I'm gonna stick that there, I think. Ready for photoing? I like my Matchbox ones far too much. You see, some of them I definitely can't part with. Like my Jag police car. And the other emergency vehicles, as it's just the ones on that cabinet I've lost interest in, really, apart from the Matchbox ones. So I'll probably get photos of those as well, get those on eBay. We're going to get rid of the red fire car, because that one was a birthday present. I'll keep that one, I'll keep the Sierra Corgi one. All the Matchbox ones, two lorries, but are the two Crown Victorias, and apart from that, I think the rest can be thrown on eBay. Actually, I might keep one of the BMWs, the one with all the red and white stripes on. Might keep that one, because I do like that one. But I don't really like the rest. Actually, I might keep both BMWs. Yeah. Right. Nope, that's a Mercedes. Polizei one. Oh, shit. I think I just put a big mark in this one. Give them a clean before I post them as well. Ouch. Let's get a handful. I think that's about as much as I can carry. Right, so in a minute, while you're walking around looking at a very peculiar angle, I'm going to shut the camera down and nearly lost that one on the floor. So I've got those ones. I'll just go get the others that I wanted to stick on. Part of me still doesn't want to sell them, but I don't think I'll miss them, to be honest. I really don't think I would. Right. Those are the ones I want to keep. These are the ones I don't want to keep. Right. Some of them have, like the white plastic in the centre there has gone a funny colour where it's been on display, but apart from that, the rest of them are alright. So I've got so many cars, I don't really want to put them all on in one go, because I'll be there hours listing them. So I'm just going to do them in lots like this. I'll put these ones on, and then that might be it for the time being. Anyway, shut the camera off and get on with this. It won't take me long just to put these few on, then I might jump in a bath and have a nice soak in a bath. By that time, I could probably call it quits for the night. So, thanks a lot for watching, as always. It's much appreciated. Thumbs up the video if you like it. If you didn't, then just thumb it down. The choice is yours. And don't forget to subscribe for more daily videos, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.